Several allegations have been raised on the arrest of key individuals on a cruise ship in Mumbai. Allegations of a larger conspiracy, the involvement of political leaders, also of private detectives. Among those arrested with Aryan Khan, the son of Shah Rukh Khan, is Arbaaz Merchant. Joining us now, Aslam Merchant, the father of Arbaaz. Thank you, sir, very much for speaking to us. In your son's bail application, you've said that he was, in fact, framed. How was he framed if a small quantity of charas was indeed found on him?
As you know, I'm an advocate.
Right.
And by my professional thing, the matter is sub judice. I'm not supposed to quote anything on the matter. I have full faith in the judiciary and I have to respect my profession. In my profession, after Almighty, judiciary is supreme. So let the truth prevail. My son, Aryan, all are innocent. They have been guests. So the guests are not supposed to come prepared with anything. So the truth has to come out. NCB is very cooperative. The children are cooperating. They're just hoping for the best. But all the days, with every passing minute, the kids are being traumatized. You have to look at the age of the kids. They are delicate darlings. So the sooner, the better. My only request and the prayer to everybody is, let the truth be prevailed ASAP and get them out immediately.
So, Mr. Merchant, just a couple of points over here. You have alleged in your, or you have stated in the bail application, your son's bail application, that he was framed. Why do you believe he was framed? How was he framed?
I would again like to say the same thing. This is a matter sub judice. I cannot quote to you on any aspect on the matter.
No, I'm asking you only about the bail application. Is that something you cannot talk about?
No, not at this point of time, because the hearing is in the next 15 minutes.
So, Mr. Merchant, let me ask you this. Because this happened yesterday. I mean, it was reported yesterday. It happened earlier. It happened on the day, in fact, that he was taken into custody. There was a BJP leader, Manish Bahushali, who was involved in all of this. He physically handled your son and took him into the NCB office. What is his involvement in all of this?
I'm not a politician nor an actor. I would love to remain out of all the aspects. Only prayer is they should come out scot-free. And no, I would again request all of you,
as the father of a man who is behind bars, who was apparently physically held by somebody, who it was Manish Bahushali, that's been established, who is apparently a part of the BJP. He's a private citizen. I'm asking you, what role has he had in this entire case?
It's fair injustice to lay a normal citizen like Arbaaz or Aryan for the matter to handle it this way. Any political party's involvement is very much uncalled for. They should not be like scapegoats for the political end. So my request to all the political parties involved, please leave the kids away from the whatever motive anybody has. With humble hands, I would just request, please stay away from the kids thing. The mentality, they are being traumatized every single minute. Though they are in good hands of the NCB, but freedom is freedom. Behind bars is behind bars. They are under the safe custody of NCB. So please do not involve anything. And if anybody does have a motive, I would again request them to leave it as it is and don't let the kids be the scapegoat.
Mr. Merchant, when did this Manish Bahushali interact with your son? Did that take place after he was arrested? On what basis was he involved?
My son is not supposed to speak to me, and the police have been, and the NCB representatives have not given us freedom to speak personally. So I'm not aware of what has transpired. Whatever has transpired in the custody of the NCB officials. They would be in a better position to know, because since the time of 2nd October till now, we have not been given even 5 minutes to talk privately.
Is that legal?
Even now,
they will be
escorted by many people.
So this is important, sir. Is it legal that you have not
it's
been
not
given
fair, no.
5 minutes to speak to your son? And as a lawyer, you are representing him, is that right?
No, my colleague Tariq Syed is representing him. He's a senior and we are fighting.
Has he had a chance to meet your son?
Not yet.
But on what basis is that allowed?
Some application.
Is that legal? I'm asking you as a lawyer, as a matter of law. Is it not correct that he needs to have access to a lawyer within 24 hours?
That is quite true. That is what he sent in an application yesterday. Today, hopefully, before the proceedings start, he shall have some free time with him. So many things might come out to be true.
Would you say, therefore, that more than, I want to be sure about this, sir, more than 24 hours has passed and your son has not gained legal access? Your son has not...
Sorry?
I'm asking you, sir, it's been 24 hours. Your son has not had access to a lawyer?
Not yet. He didn't have an access to the lawyer.
Please carry on. I'm listening to you, sir. Go ahead. He does
he
not have access
to
the lawyer.
He had access very, very brief, very, very brief for a minute with NCB officials covering him. But private meeting he has not had as till now, which is against the law. And let's hope for the best that after the applications which my colleague has given to the tendered to the court, maybe today he will have some free time and a lot of things might come out in the open ASAP.
What can you tell us about the role of this detective, sir? There was a private man, a detective, a private investigator of sorts. Mr. Merchant, I will keep you for only 5 more minutes. And I'm not looking, you know, I'm looking at basic
2 minutes
questions.
Is fine.
Who was this detective, sir?
I would not be able to quote at this point of time. As I've told everybody, we are from the timber industry last 75 years. Who is doing what? So I am in a profession of law, but my thing is not to go on those levels of seeing who's the detective and who's behind whom. So as of this point of time, let the truth prevail. Nothing will be behind. I mean, everything will come out in the open as soon as possible. And we simply hope and pray for the best.
Do you accept what the NCP said yesterday in their press conference? The NCP, Mr. Malik, their senior leader, made a series of allegations basically saying that this was also a political conspiracy. Do you believe your son has been caught in a political conspiracy?
Mr. Nawab Malik, respected sir, has whatever given a statement, he is given with evidence. And the evidence was loud and clear.
Okay, the evidence was loud and clear. And a final question to you. Do you believe that your son and some of the others are have been targeted when in fact there is a bigger motive, perhaps targeting Bollywood? Now, we've seen this in the Ria case. Are we
Very
seeing
true.
Some targeting of Bollywood and those associated with Bollywood? It's an allegation, I'm asking you, sir.
Very much true. Very much true. My son is not from the Bollywood industry. He's just a friend. And as I said, he's from the timber industry. Whomsoever they must be wanting to target. And he's just been caught wrong person at the wrong time. So let's hope and pray for the best. And again, I'm reiterating the fact. Just look at the tender age. Whichever parties are targeting whom, just look at the age. Look at the trauma their respective moms are facing. Well, my wife has been crying over the last 2 days. The same goes for everybody's mom. So they are parents, even you, your brother, your anybody, if it comes to you, if you are old or anybody else is there, they can understand and sympathize with the fact that nobody should play with the kids' tender age.
All right, Mr.
Leave
Merchant.
Aside any political motives. I'm not here to comment to anybody.
All right. Well, Mr. Merchant, hopefully there will be justice. Everybody wants justice one way or the other. In this particular case, thank you very much for speaking to us. Thanks very much indeed.
Anybody who's honest and been implicated falsely will sincerely sympathize with them and simply pray. As I said, my wife is from a Punjabi background. I believe in Allah, I believe in Bhagwan, I believe in anything, but let the Almighty give prayers and let everybody come out.
No, but Mr. Merchant, there is one key aspect of this. You. It was my first question. I must ask you, was your son found with 6 grams of charas, yes or no? Or was that planted on him?
Not at all. Not at all. It's a simple allegation and they have been implicated wrongly. But as of again I say, I am not here to comment matters sub judice.
All right.
So, no comments. Let the truth prevail.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you very much.
Asraf Merchant over there, the father of Arbaaz Merchant, coming out and saying a couple of key points. One of them is that his son was falsely implicated, that he was not, Arbaaz Merchant was not, according to the father, who's also a lawyer, was not in possession of any drugs. The Narcotics Control Bureau has stated that he was in possession of approximately 6 grams of charas. He also says that his son is a pawn, essentially, in a larger political conspiracy or some sort of a conspiracy targeting Bollywood. So that's a series of allegations that he has made.